Today I'm going over our function chapter. Remaining questions in exercise 2.3. In the question number 5, find the range of the given functions. And function is fx 2 minus 3x, where x belongs to any real number, x greater than 0. Students, it is a IMT questions for exam oriented. For real number x belongs to R, x greater than 0, I just explained for x greater than 0. And preparing this 2 minus 3x, so first multiply by 3 on both sides. Here this makes sense. We multiply 3 on both sides. So what you get? Only you getting 3x, but here greater than 0. But I want the 3x outside minus. So minus multiply. Whenever you minus multiply, inequality change. Same. Multiply. Minus 1. On both sides. So here minus 3x. Here less than 0. Now what you get? 2. So here just you write down 2. Adding on both sides. Yes, students, finish your sum. It's your answer less than 2. It means you just show out the number line. Here 2. Less is this left side. This answer minus infinity to 2. And this indicates your answer as less than 2. Yes, so what is your answer range? Our range is minus infinity to 2 open bracket. Either student this also 2x as that x less than 2, x belongs to R, this answer. Okay, and that is your simple, our one of the parts done. It is your range. Now second question. Second fx is given. It is your x square plus 2 for x belongs to R, real number. So very easy. Every real number, students, I just show out to real. Here minus infinity, 0 and plus infinity. It is a R plus, R minus and including 0. It is called real numbers. So for x belongs to R, you know that it is R negative, union 0, union R positive. If I picking first of all square, yes, every square term definitely it is known negative. Yes, it is known negative. Why students I declare it is known negative? Because negative and 0 and positive, all numbers, if you take in square, your answer is either 0, either positive. So it is a known negative. Now x square plus 2, I want plus 2, only adding that, here plus 2, here plus 2. So what you get, x square plus 2 here, it is greater than or equal to 2, only I adding 2 numbers, both sides. Just only 2. So students, you have numerical done because your question x square plus 2 greater than or equal to finished. I just show out the drawing. Here you have 2. More than means is the right side moving plus infinity. And or equal to means these are or equal. And you are going just right side moving that plus infinity. So this indicate your answer x greater than or equal to 2. So what is your answer for the range? Yes, range is close bracket 2 to plus infinity. Yes, otherwise x as that x greater than or equal to 2, x belongs to R. These answers are easily done for question number 2. If you students here plus 5 given, I just show out here plus 5 and plus 5, then answer is here 5 to more than size. different number also given minus 2, minus 3. So any given, you easily define your answer by that. Now continue students, question number 3. 3 is your question, fx is equal to only x, for x belongs to real. So this answer is fx is equal to x, x is a real. Any power it is single, surely graph is a straight line. So I am just taking for some numbers related my graph to drawing and after that deciding what is your range. Students, here you are taking some numbers. Any number take from your domain x belongs to R. So here I am taking the some numbers. X plus 1, then here 1, 2, 3, 4, 0, minus 1. So I am sure you understood that type of table x and y. Easily done. Your graph 1 then 1, 2 then 2, 3 then 3, 4 then 4, 0 then 0, minus 1 then minus 1. And graph is also done. Graph is a straight line. Yes, some numbers apply. 0, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. Yeah, 1, 2, 3. And this side moving 1, 2, 3. Y axis. Yes. So, point plotting. 1 then 1, 2 then 2, 3 then 3, same 0 then 0, minus 1 then minus 1, means your graph is a straight line, sure. Students, 0 indicate and this answer is indicate your R plus and this indicate R minus. So, what is your domain? Our domain is a R and range. Range is a R. Plus 0 and R minus. Indirectly students, I told it is R. Here also domain is R. If you are asking domain, then you show out it is R. But range asking then to infinity. Here range asking R plus 0 and R minus. So it's very easy. Now I am going to, after ending this exercise students, I am going to exercise 2. Now continue students, question number first for exercise 2. Students, in this exercise, there are repeated questions and revised for our full chapter. Question 1. Given relation f and g are the given and show that f is a function and g is not a function. So where is a function? First of all, you clear in your mind, every domain element, yes, every domain elements are uniquely associated with codomain, yes, then it is a function. So I start one by one for your fx. So for fx, what is the fx first value? X square, 0 less than, x less than 3, and same as I check now to second, fx is a 3x, but 3 less than x less than 10. And all value I one by one calculate. First of all, 0, 1, 2, 3. Yes. Apply that 0 square, 1 square, 2 square, 3 square, 9. And same as here, students, 3, 4, 5, 6. 7, 8, 9 and 10, all data, one by one, you put down there. Yes, because my domain is 3 less than or equal to x, less than or equal to 10. And 3x will be applied, so 3, 3 is a 9, 4, 3 is a 12, 5, 3 is a 15, 6, 3 is a 18, 7, 3 is a 21, 8, 3 is a 24, 9, 3 is a 27, now I am checking it is a function or not. Yes, I am going to our first of all here domain and here codomain. There are only values 0. 0, 1, 2, 3. And this side continue to 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Apply the value 0 putting, then answer is 0. Second, 1 putting, then 1. 2 putting, then 4. Yes. 3 putting, then 9. Check here, every elements of domain uniquely associated? Yes. After 9, again repeat that. 4, then 12. 5, then 15. 6, then 18. 7, then 21. 8, then 24. 9, then 27. And last, 10, then 30. And these all are uniquely associated with the codomain. So sure, yes. Relation. F is function. Reason same right now, students, you? Here, every element of domain is uniquely associated with the codomain. And this part here affects in students. Done. Now I start GX. And GX I also check into similarly here and prove that GX is a not a function. Yes, students. Now, GX is x squared. Sum 0 less than x less than 2. And secondly, GX is your 3x. Sum 2 less than x less than 10. So, both values similarly I calculate by this rule. So, both of the 1 by 1 going, we are applying to G0, G1, G2, and value fit. So, we are applying 0 step. 1 square, 2 square, you get 0, 1, 4. Same as here, students. G2, G3, G4, G5, G6, G7, G8, G9, and G10. All data you know. Now, I want the value for the 3x, so 3 into 2, 6, 9, 12, 15, 6 is 18, 21, 24, 27, and 30. Now, checking same rule, domain and codomain. Yes, for domain value is a 0, 1, 2. 0 putting then 0 answer, 1 putting then 1, 2 putting then 4, now here checking, again 2 putting then 6, yes students, it is a changing your result, check, here element for domain, uniquely associated, no, it is not a function, so continue, 3 then 6, F2, 6, F3, 9, F4, 12, 5, 15, 6, 18, 7, 21, 8, 24, 9, 27, and 10, it is a 13. And these values all are uniquely associated, but only these two are not unique. So here element of domain 2 is not unique associated with the codomain. So it is not a function. After that I tell students it is not a function. This relation G is our order function confirmed because these are not uniquely associated domain element to our codomain elements. Yes, students. Now I will go ahead. Question number 2. If f x even in the terms of x square and find out f of 1.1 minus f 1 upon 1.1 minus 1. So here also same is. It's very simple, students. I first derive 1.1 and f 1. So what is the 1.1? 1.1 square. 1.21. Yes, 11 square. 1.21. And what is the f 1? It is also 1. So value of f 1.1 minus f 1 upon 1.1 minus 1. Very easy numerical. Apply the value. It is 1.21 minus f 1 is a 1 upon 1.1 minus 1. 0.1. Yes, finally getting 1.21 minus 1. It is 0.21 upon 0.1. It means 21 by 100. We have 1 by 10. So, 21 by 100 into 10 by 1 is cancelled. Your answer is 21 by 10. It means 2.1. And this question are happily, easily done. Our 1 mark question. Either students, 2 marks question. Yes, now I bring to the next question. Now, students, after ending this easy numerical, I go into question number 3. This question is the IMP for examiner, students. Find the domain of this given function. Function given, px by qx. Yes, it is a rational function. Yes, what is the rational function meaning? Px by qx, where necessary, qx never zero. Yes, qx never zero. So it is a rational function. So first of all, I just check out our rational functions and easily I go in. So this function fx, students, I just calculate by property of our rational function. This rational function property, denominator never zero. So here denominator x square minus 8x plus 12 never zero. This I further calculate. Finish sum. Okay, 12 factor 8 carry. So 6 2s are common, taking x minus 6 minus 2 x minus 6. So finally getting x minus 6 and x minus 2. Yes, one of the factor x minus 6 not equal to 0 and x minus 2 not equal to 0. It means, students, first of all x never 6 and x never 2. It means in every real numbers 6 and 2 are not counted in this answer. So my numerical is done. Here domain is r minus 6 comma 2. Means every number belonging in this domain other than only 6 and 2. It means also I have domain. Yes, other value other than 6 and 2 in real number. This is your answer. Either r minus 6 comma 2 is also your final answer for domain. Yes, students. Now I going to next question. Question number 4. One more interesting question, students. We are running now. Question number 4. Find domain and range. Fx is equal to under root x minus 1. Yes, we know that. What do you know? Every square root value. Again, repeat. Every square root value is always non-negative. Yes, students. Always any function given in the root, always non-negative. And internal x minus 1 as it is, taking square on both side. Definitely you can get in here one of the x minus 1, and here greater than or equal to 0. Adding both side on 1, you just getting x greater than or equal to 1. It means these are the our number line. Here 1 included, and more than one side running. It means this region is your answer, students. So what is here? One of the domain. Yes, my domain is a close bracket 1 to infinity. Either I also write down in this form x such that x greater than or equal to 1, x belongs to R. These answers are also true. And now using this domain, I start our range. Yes, it's very easy process, students. I hope you understood. Using my our number line, you necessary draw this drawing, huh? Then you properly understood. So, what is domain again? Repeat. Our domain is x greater than or equal to 1. But I want students under root x minus 1. That's why I taking subtraction on both sides 1. Subtracted 1 on both sides. So what you get? Here x minus 1. But here greater than or equal to 0. Now I want the under root. Yes, square root to each term. Yes, square root to 0 term. Yes, finish sum. This your quotient done here. Here 0 included. 2 greater than size moving. This is here are the increasing in this way. And plus infinity side, here minus infinity. So my range is, what is range? Close bracket 0 to plus infinity. Either R plus union 0 is also true, because this part is R plus, these are minus. Either this also true, R, this full number line, minus this R minus this portions. Your answer is 0 and R plus. It is known negative as students. And that answer you create easily. Question number 4. Here done. Now students, I move ahead. Question number 5. Question is that x is equal to modulus x minus 1 and find domain and range. So before starting this question, I think you know, students, every modulus function graph is a union of two rays, either positive y side, either negative y side. So this graph is also, students, I show up here first, and after that I apply our domain and range. Yes, some values I am taking to plotting this graph. Just here taking 2x and y is your fx. Is your question x minus 1. First of all, taking I just minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2. Either for the number also taking extra 3, 4, 5. Any you taking as you like. Now putting the value. If x minus 3, then what is fx? It is minus 3 minus 1. Surely minus 4. Answer is 4. Yes, here putting answer minus 4. Next, if x is equal to minus 2, then fx x minus 1. Apply the value minus 2 minus 1, which is minus 3. Yes, this answer is a 3. Here not minus 4, minus 3. That value is a 4 and 3. Continue. Now I need to shortcut. If x is equal to minus 1, then f of minus 1. Minus 1, minus 1, minus 2 modulus? Answer is 2. If x is equal to 0, then add 0. 0 minus 1, yes, it is 1. Continue. If x is equal to 1, then what is f1 now? Yes, applying the fx, x is 1. 1 minus 1, it is 0. Continue. If x is equal to 2, so before plotting your graph, students, you must be taking some numbers in this table wise. 2 minus 1. Continue. If x is equal to 3, so what is f3? 3 minus 1, 2. So your answer is here. 2 putting then 1, 3 putting then 2, if you 4 putting then 3, then you have 4, just like now I am going to our graph. It's very easy graph, students. X-axis sum, y-axis here 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, any number taking the students, here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 axis. So, now I start systematically plotting, 0 to start, 0 then 1, here, 1 then 0, here, 2 then 1, that one, 3 then 2, this one, 4 then 3, exactly here, 5 then 4, exactly here, and this side is running to straight lines, it is R positive, because this is our axis, positive moving, it is negative axis, it is R minus, if you downwards given the graph. Now, here, continue to minus 1 then 2, means here approximately, minus 2 then 3, means here approximately. So your graph is going to be this side, upwards to also here upwards. Further validating minus 3 then 4, approximately here, students. Don't worry, you are plotting some number this side and this side. The graph is what? Union of 2 rays in R plus 0 also present here, answer C. And R plus. So what is my domain? Domain is any number in R, but range is R plus union 0. Means again taking node negative. Yes, students, it is node negative. Either you write down R minus or R minus. It is also same result. And here, easily and happily over these questions. Now I go ahead slowly. Next one. Yes, students, after ending this sum, I am going to one more numerical. It is interesting. And IMP for exam level. So, tick mark in IMP list. Question is there, x comma x square by 1 plus x square. In x belongs to R. Be a function from R to R. Find out range. Yes, students, here you consider this x, but that is consider y. So, y is equal to x square by 1 plus x square. Well, x belongs to any real number. Yes, students. Again, I explain the real number. Here, R positive range. Either write down infinity plus, here infinity minus, here 0. And this region you just show up. It is R plus. And this region is showing up. It is R minus. So, R negative, 0 and R positive, all R. If you are taking square, it means for x belongs to R. If you are making square, definitely your answer is non negative. Surely. Now I just adding to 1 because I want it. If you are adding to 1, both sides you are getting just x square plus 1 is greater than or equal to 1. So, what is value for x square by x square plus 1? Yes, if you both this divided, surely greater than or equal to 0. But less than 1. So, finally, your 0 to 1 value is defined. 0 less than 1 less than 1. Yes, students, here I will be very good. But I think you are thinking why I write down here less than 1. Yes, I explain you. Wait. Please consider your effects. Explanation for this one, why I write down less than 1. Just putting here some numbers, 0 putting them. What is your answer? Yes, 0. If I putting 1 then, answer is half. If you plus or minus 1 then, same answer. If you apply plus or minus 2 then, 4 by 1 plus 4, it is 4 by 5. If you apply plus or minus 3 then, here 9 by 1 plus 9, 9 by 10, check. These answer never more than 1 and not equal to 1, always less than 1, check. That's why I write down here less than 1. Clear? Yes, it means your answer bounded between 0 and up to 1. So, what is your domain here? Domain in the question is R, but range is R. Close bracket 0 to 1 in open bracket. Yes, students. Here, close bracket or not in open bracket. And in your textbook, there are wrong printed. Here, open bracket written. So, you make the correction in your textbook. Here, write down the close bracket because here 0 is included in these solutions. That's why I write down, students. Here, 6th one is our final answer in close bracket 0 to 1. Either you also show this answer, x as that, 0 less than x, less than 1, and x belongs to R. That are the final answer. Yes, students. I hope, students, you understood that 10 questions. Now, here ending, students, our this part. Further explanations and the remaining illustration and remaining questions for in these chapters, I explain you in the next part. Bye-bye. See you.